assistant for associated students of UCLA.
Guys, it's my favorite Chinese place. My favorite Chinese. Real, authentic Chinese. What's happening, everyone? Welcome back to another episode of Boba and Basketball, the show where I talk about my two favorite kind of balls, boba and basketball. I'm in Pasadena, California right now just to get some food because I am so hungry and I want food. So right now I should tell you first that we are going to a women's basketball game between the UCLA Bruins and the Colorado Buffaloes. Why am I doing women's basketball? Well, because for one, I wanted to do at least one women's basketball episode. And two, I will explain later as we get closer to the game. But for now, I am so hungry. I got myself a burrito from a place called Lucky Boy. It's a place in Pasadena, very well known for their famous breakfast burrito. And I am so hungry, guys. Look at this. This is massive. Unbelievably huge. Oh my goodness. So here we go, guys. We're gonna try some right now. I got myself a bacon. It is a bacon, egg, and cheese with this salsa. Oh my god, I'm so happy. This is amazing. The home fry, the eggs, the cheese. This thing is massive. I'm so glad all I ate was a banana. Good thing I saved up for this because this is incredible. Look at that filling. Mmm. This is so good. Again, the place is called Lucky Boy. It's in Pasadena, California. I'm gonna finish the rest of this behemoth of a burrito. I'm not sure where to get boba, but you guys can come with me and we'll go find something somewhere to get boba.
Okay, I wanted to show you guys something really interesting in Pasadena because it's free. There is a fork in the road. A couple guys in Pasadena decided to build a fork in the road. They just put it up and now there's a fork in the road. I don't know, this is really cool. It's free. It only takes like 2 minutes to look at. I think it's amusing. Alrighty, now that we're done hitting that fork in the road, we're gonna go to a place called OinkMoo Tea Bar. Very excited, so let's go drive over there and make our way. I need a cha-cha, big boy.
Myself a taro fresh milk, so it's with the taro and then it has real milk, so like dairy milk. They have subs like almond and oat milk, soy milk, but let's try it. Oh my god, this is so smooth. It's so pretty. It's so smooth. Oh my god, I love this so much. The boba is so good. And the taro is so not too sweet. If you've ever had ube, this tastes like ube. This is so good. She's so pretty. This is such a pretty drink. Also, this place is so cool.
So it's apparently inspired by Burlington Arcade in London. So that's why this looks very like old school, very old timey. You know, very like European, London. London's a cool place. That's all I've heard.
And the place is called OinkMoo Tea Bar. Amazing place. Go check it out. Highly recommend it.
So I kind of came to LA pretty early. I didn't want to get stuck on the way to LA, you know, because traffic is terrible in LA. And it's terrible even now because it is a Friday today. So it's game is at 7 and right now it's 2:30. I don't know what to do. I might just walk around some places in LA. If I find something interesting, I'll show you guys, but otherwise I'll see you at UCLA or I'll see you at whatever I do. It's a spontaneous trip. Most of my trips I've done are pretty spontaneous, so, you know, I'll find something, guys.
Alrighty, so I decided to not really do anything else after Pasadena. I kind of just drove around LA for a little bit, and then I'm currently in a parking lot in UCLA. It's kind of hard to do stuff when you're only here for a day, but I guess you guys get to come down. We can walk around campus for a little bit, and then we'll make our way inside the arena.
Alrighty guys, I'm inside Poly Pavilion on the campus of UCLA. It is Breast Cancer Awareness Night here. Play for K is what they're calling it. I am 100% fully supportive of the cancer awareness movement. But also, first 1,000 fans that came here got a free shirt. I got a free shirt, guys. Also, I was going to mention the second reason why I'm here at UCLA watching a women's game. One of the players on the UCLA women's team goes by the name of Natalie Chou. And Natalie Chou is not the first Asian-American woman to play college basketball. There are plenty that have played. But the reason I want to come and see Natalie Chou is because she was the first Asian-American woman that I learned of that played college basketball. And she had, at the time, she had played at Baylor, a very historic women's program, and then she transferred here to UCLA. She is the first Asian-American ever to make the McDonald's All-American. That's the, like, McDonald's high school all-stars. She was the first to make on the USA national team as a, I believe, a high schooler. So I wanted to watch Natalie Chou play because, you know, Asian represent. I love my Asians, bro. I love it. Anything Asians, you know, we get crazy, but especially in sports. You know, remember Lynn Sandy like 10 years ago? Yeah, we went crazy. And now I wanted to see Natalie Chou, so I'm super excited. Like, seriously, like, she's warming up right now in front of me. I sound weird, but, like, dude, like, it's a big deal for us. For me, at least. At the end of the first quarter, it's tied 17-17. Women's college basketball is a little different. They go 4 10-minute quarters instead of college men's basketball. They do 2 20-minute halves. So there you go. At the end of the first half, Colorado has the lead 37-30. I gotta tell you guys, Poly Pavilion is the nicest place I've been to so far of all the venues. Granted, all the places I've been to have been smaller schools, but like, unbelievable. It's beautiful, guys. Colorado has a 15-point lead, 59-44, heading into the fourth quarter. UCLA's got a lot of catching up to do. Well, it wasn't UCLA tonight, and the Colorado Buffaloes win this one 67-54. It was a tough one. They just couldn't make the basket. UCLA just couldn't shoot. They had a struggling game. But in terms of Natalie Chou, she only scored 3 points. But you know what? I'm so happy I got to see her. I was really happy that I got to do this. I really wanted to see one of my favorite college basketball players. I'm so happy that I got to see Natalie Chou, and she scored at least one, so I'm like happy at least. Also, I gotta say once again, Poly Pavilion, the best place I've been to so far. Awesome venue, so pretty, so nice. Oh my goodness, I'm just like, it was a really nice place. I guess it's when you go to a bigger school, you get a bigger gym, you get a better, bigger, nicer gym. So you know what, 13,000 seat capacity gym, arena, awesome. Alrighty, I just found out that my friend is here, so we're gonna go say hi to someone. And he can do the outro with us.
You wanna be in it?
Yeah, sure. Ayo, Kale Gang, what's poppin'?
This is Mikee, everyone.
Yeah, we're here at UCLA, the physics building, floor 5. We are currently looking out at the campus. There's LA right here.
All of this is ours, right?
Yeah, everything the light touches is ours. But oh. It looks like there's no light out, so. That's cool.
It's cool?
What about like high school, since that was the last time we
oh my god, what do you remember high school graduation?
It felt like I was reborn. I feel like that was when my...
Do you want to tell them what you did at graduation?
I hit the wall on stage. That was fun.
He hit the wall on our principal.
Yeah, I was like...
And then the principal asked him to do it again.
Yeah, he's like, I like that. Do it again. So I did it again. I was like...
You know what happened during mine?
What?
So our principal's name is Principal Magno, but I accidentally said mango. Like, not as a joke. Like, as a total accident. Because you went to community college as well.
It's been a wild ride since you last saw me. So I was at... Miramar for 2 years, and at the beginning of that 2 years I started posting on TikTok, and over that time I gained like 300,000 followers and 20 million likes. So I don't know, my life's changed a lot since then, and I transferred to UCLA after 2 years at community college, shout out Miramar. And yeah, now we're here. Now I just love my life now. Like, things are great.
I mean, like, you're at UCLA.
Where are
where
we going?
Where? I don't know. You're the one that walked. Let's go.
Yeah, I don't know. Like, I'm so thankful for everything right now. Just because, like, I literally live in a hotel with all my friends in LA. I'm chasing my dreams on TikTok. And I don't know. I'm doing well in school. I feel like everything I've ever wanted in life, I either have it right now or I'm on the path to getting it. And I'm just thankful for everything. And like, yeah, I don't see how life could get better than this.
Mikee, you want to plug your TikTok for the people?
Yeah, it's at MikeeF02. MikeeF02.
It'll be in the description, my guys.
Yeah.
How have we changed since high school? You want me to tell about how you changed?
Yeah.
Yeah, even more. You're more extrovert. You're more out there. You're more outgoing.
Like, did you just determine that, like, when you first met me, like a few?
No, when ago? I met you, wait, I,
when, like,
in
a few
fresh
minutes ago, like at the basketball arena, were you just like, oh, this is a different person, or?
No, you were still Mikee to me. Because we're like, we're closer than, like, you know, like other people. You know, we're not close, but you know, we've been friends for a while.
So, like, in the span of time that we've been talking, like today, you're like, oh, this is a more extroverted person.
Yeah, you used to just end conversations in like 2 minutes.
Yeah, I just didn't have like the social skills back then.
No,
I felt like trapped in my own body because like I couldn't express myself.
Which way? Left or straight?
I can't.
Left or straight?
Like, let's go this way.
Straight? Okay, cool.
I just feel like all the character development for me happened after high school. Like, let's just get off the road. That's over. But like, yeah, like after high school, like at the end of high school, I got a job at Krispy Kreme.
I remember that shit, bro.
Yeah, it forced me to talk to people for 8 hours a day at a drive-thru, at the cash register. And I just like got better at my speaking skills and my social skills through that. And then I started TikTok shortly after that, and that also helped me with my speaking skills, my social skills. And it just helped me like come up with topics to talk about. It's like literally when you make TikTok, it's like you're befriending the audience. You're like talking.
No, for real though. You love talking to people. It looks like you talk to people.
Really?
You're just like, oh my god.
Is there a fountain in here?
At the beginning of the school year, when you go on a tour here, they're like, lay on your belly here and dip your hand in the fountain and say this oath. And then they're like, okay, you cannot touch the fountain until after you graduate, or bad luck.
So they haven't touched it since.
Yeah, they call it like Bruinsizing, which is like baptizing for Bruins.
Ooh. See, very nice.
Oh, this is cool.
Yeah, I've never seen it at night, but it's cool.
It's cool.
Ooh,
it's glowy. Whoa.
Thank you guys for watching. This has been a UCLA tour with Kyle and then Mikee. We had a lot of deep discussions today about our lives since high school and about where we want to go, and just, I don't know, it was cool just catching up. And like, I feel like
I walked into my intro.
Yeah, I feel like I walked into a time machine and I went back to 2019. I was like, I don't know, it's crazy.
This is really cool, guys. So thank you guys for watching. Go check out Lucky Boy and OinkMoo Tea Bar in Pasadena. Go check out Poly Pavilion at UCLA. Thank you once again, Mikee, for being here. Thank you for the tour. Thank you for joining me. Really appreciate it. Make sure you follow me on TikTok.
Yeah, at MikeeF02 on TikTok. It's on the screen right now.
And I will see you guys at the next game.
Peace.